Welcome to the Gallery podcast, where we, as the team, will be talking about our work integrated learning experiences. We will each get a question from the board, read out our question. After we read our question, we'll deliberate amongst each other on our experiences. And we will start on my right.
Describe StratCom as a person.
Ayo.
What the fuck is StratCom?
What is it? Teacher communication.
No, like, I know what it is. Like, what am
but
I?
But as a person?
As a person. As a
person. To me, StratCom is like my love that doesn't want me, but I want it.
That's a good answer.
Yes.
It's such a
good answer. It's a good answer.
Where do you see yourself in the future of StratCom with the rise of AI? Mm. Where do I see myself in the future? AI can't do everything that I can. Okay. Number one. AI is technologically strategized, yes, but it doesn't have my creativity. So yes, my creativity is gonna lead me where I wanna be. So I'm in the future.
On your PR journey, what would you tell your first yourself? Okay. Firstly, I would tell myself, my first yourself, or like do research about PR, understand it better, because now it's just moving with the flow.
I was like, oh, that's nice. But I did apply for other varsities. Didn't answer me recently, but
I assessed the salary, guys.
Wait, how much is it?
What is the salary?
Yeah.
I might do it.
What I saw on Google was 30 to 40K.
Yes.
Okay.
Is it true though?
It is. Yeah. It depends whether you're in the governmental one or corporate. Corporate pays better.
Corporate.
But there are more benefits.
What motivates you to be a strategic communicator? That's interesting. What motivates me to be a strategic communicator? It's wanting more out of life, man. It's wanting to understand the workings of everything and of human psychology, because PR is it's all about understanding how the general public is going to relate to whatever you're doing. It's like you're this bridge. So for me, what motivates me is actually becoming that bridge and ensuring that I'm linking the necessary coasts together, you know, so that people can. I don't want to say live better lives, because that feels like a pipe dream, you know. Part of me feels like the world is never going to change.
Yeah,
but it can't.
Part of me feels like the world is never going to change.
And communication, and in that long, we're keeping up with the trends.
Change. I mean, at the same time, I do feel like the world is going to change. So what motivates me to be a strategic communicator is the fact that.
Yep, I saw your placement. No, my only skill is to be pretty.
Yeah.
I only talk when it's necessary.
Understanding of paradigm shifts with your
creativity.
I'm still asking the question.
It's making me talk better. It's my team as well.
And your team has better outside eyes.
No.
Okay. Okay. Well, I thought Will is a complicated. It is a complicated thing, yeah? But I thought I was not gonna do it. I felt like it was too much for me. But now I feel like because I'm in this space, I feel like well, things are getting better. There's direction. There's
light.
Yeah, there's hope. There's light. I can see the light. I mean, this whole project is not an easy thing, but it's doable.
Yeah, we're doing something about it. And we're doing it.
And kind of paradigm, I also feel like Kale, and maybe, I don't know, Kale would, it would be the traditional way, first year, second year, third year, graduation. Mm-hmm. Then now we have this process where we get to experience work life within, like, well,
our
within our coursework. So if maybe other modules and courses could do this, imagine our country.
I didn't know about this until we were here, guys.
A lot of courses actually, apparently they don't. Some of them have even removed it. That's why also like we've been pushed. Like that's why also like our main Miss Renee, Mrs. MMA, is actually like pushing this whole thing because she wants Will to stick around for PR because we need it.
Yeah.
Because I think it's also gonna help push the fact that you know the whole thing of people underestimate PR.
Mm.
You know, so. With Will, it also helps us to, you know, have that bit of experience before we can walk into the industry.
Yeah.
So that's it. So that we don't underestimate PR when we're done with school.
Yeah.
You know, and feel like, hey, what we're doing is worthless because the experience is what actually puts you in a position of seeing what's in. Shit, I can actually do a lot with this thing.
And
this
is actually fine.
And you can!
You know,
there's one thing that I learned about PR. PR is needed
everywhere.
They just don't know what PR
exactly.
is. And they're like, why wouldn't PR communicate?
Why are you doing this?
Anybody can do that.
And not everyone can communicate.
Yeah.
It's not what. It's not as
good. Okay, what led you to join this project? Okay, for me, I wasn't ready for a working space because I was like, and the way I'm going to a toxic environment, waking up in the morning, and I was like, okay, they brought this project up. It's a 2-in-1. I love being in theater. I love filming. So it's doing what I love, you know, 2-in-1, you know, the chocolate. This is my portfolio could even help me from a profile in terms of like acting and stuff. So it was like, you know what? I'm having fun with people. I've never worked with people before, but their connection is just, you know, too much. And I'm like, Gatena.
I've actually done this before, so I mustn't be so scared. In your years of doing strategic communication, how have you reimagined your future? So before like I came to UJ to study PR, I thought I was just gonna be like, I was gonna be famous. I was like, I wanna be a star, like I'm just going to get a record deal or something like that, or act or just do anything I'm asked. But then I was just like I love performing but it's not like forever. So I need something that I can still work with artists. But like maybe in the background, and I'll be like in a niche area because I understand what it means to be an artist and also in communication and how to work with artists.
Okay.
That is dope.
I thought I was gonna be big because PR or whatever.
Oh,
PR,
you
know,
big child.
Instagram page.
I was thinking. They're going to want us to actually learn how to speak to the people, how to know what to say.
Which
communication
did you guys Google?
But
I didn't Google.
You know
what
I did?
Honestly,
like,
what
did
I
get?
Okay.
So
guys Googled.
What
I knew.
What do you mean?
You
know
what
I
mean?
My
So you just chose something else like
the yeah.
Now what I knew is that you basically relate to someone.
Yeah.
You relate to someone. You choose either you want to be entertainment in the government industry or the sports. So I was more into entertainment industry. But I'm right.
Tell them, guys, I know you don't know PR, but I'm afraid they were just because you choose that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, yeah. What is PR and everything, Emo? Yeah. And if ever one of them, but I'm like, okay, I still want to do something like that. I'm like,
you go, yeah, you 30. Go, my friend.
That's no, like, no, 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 no. We had to research, like, what's this PR thing? I'm like, girl, I'm gonna go read the news. Like, I'm gonna be in front of the TV, I'm gonna read the news. And then, like, how do you know? I'm like, if you find out a PR, now, PR has got everything to do about media, television, radio. And my thing was like, yeah, kola kola, you guys. I said like this at the table, and I'm like, hi, this is Alia Maketa, reading Jonas Big News.
I even have a thing, a style for kola kola FM, because it's so funny. I'm like, when you go nani, you're going to say, we come to this, but
Lamutam, Numzana Jacob Zuma.
Guys!
Okay, podcast. 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 Podcast.